How's it going, people, subscribers of Mr. Haney's channel? This is Science with Mr. Haney, and today we're coming at you, and we will be talking about forms of energy, because in my class right now, we're learning about energy. So, I have some special guests here to help me out to teach y'all about the forms of energy, and we're going to go over five of them. So, to help us with this, we have the immaculate Trevor Cruz. We have the amazing and yet unpredictable Cash Morgan. We have the terrific Tanner Henke. And the undeniably great Zane Peterson. So this is my panel of guests and hosts that will help me explain to y'all the forms of energy. So let's start with the first form of energy, which is light energy. Cash, what can you tell us about light energy?
Light energy is light, like the sun.
Okay, yeah. Light energy, one of the biggest sorts of light energy we have comes from the sun. What is so special about light energy, Cash?
It helps us see things.
It helps us see things.
Because if we didn't have light energy.
And light energy is the only energy that we can
see
because it's light. All right. Now, we're going to go to our next helper here, Trevor Cruz. Trevor's going to help us learn the basics about heat energy. So, Trevor, what can you tell us about heat energy?
Heat, if you take some wood and you rub them, if you have one piece of wood down and you take another stick and you rub it,
okay, so
it makes heat.
So what are you doing with this right here? What kind of energy are you using right here?
Thermal.
So you're using mechanical energy to make
heat
energy. So would you say that heat and mechanical energy, like, a lot of the times happen together?
Yes,
absolutely. Yeah. Now, one last question. Do all things have heat energy?
Yes.
Yeah,
yes.
They do. What about an ice cube?
Yes.
What about snow?
Yes.
What about liquid? What about frozen nitrogen?
Yes.
They all have heat. They might feel cold to us because we have a lot more heat energy, but all matter has heat energy, and all matter is moving, even though it seems like it's still. This table seems like it's not moving, but the molecules in this desk are moving. They're just moving really fast and not very far apart. All right, let's move on to our next one. Tanner Henke, can you please tell us what mechanical energy is?
Mechanical energy is like if you open a door.
Yeah. Like, mechanical energy is any energy that does what?
That moves.
Good job, Tanner. I didn't know there's two of you now. Yes, mechanical energy is any energy of movement. Mechanical energy is the energy of movement. Can you demonstrate a mechanical energy for us, Tanner, right there? Perfect, yeah, just moving your hands. It takes energy. Okay, anything with movement. Water flowing down a river, mechanical energy. Wind blowing through a fan, mechanical energy. Okay, me running as fast as the flash, mechanical energy. All right, and then now we're going to go to another one. All right, Zane, why don't you break down electrical energy for us? How do we make electrical energy? Just give him a second, guys. He's finishing his bite of goldfish.
Okay. Electrical energy can produce light energy. It can turn into, it produces light.
A lot of the energy that we use that makes our light, makes our fans, keep us cool in the summer, that helps our Xboxes, so we can play Xbox, so that we can watch movies on our TV, that's all electrical energy powered. Now, is all electrical energy just come from, like, outlets at our house?
No.
Can y'all name any other examples of electrical energy? Trevor?
You can take a bowl, like a cup of water, and then have a fan go into it, and it'll spin really fast, and it'll go to a generator, and the generator will produce electricity.
Okay, yeah. What about a battery? Is battery electrical energy?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's not. It might not be being used. It might not be kinetic electrical energy, but it's potential electricity because it's in there, just waiting on somebody to plug it into like a remote or something, right?
Yeah.
All right. What about a lightning bolt? What kind of energy is that?
That is kinetic electrical energy.
That is kinetic electrical energy. It's happens when there's a storm. Those electrons and protons and the molecules get charged, create that electrical current that takes the form of a lightning bolt. And the last one, which is one of my favorites, because I deal with this energy every single day, nonstop. No matter how much I try to prevent this energy from happening, I can't stop it for some reason. That is sound energy. My students love sound energy. They produce it 24/7. Okay, and sound energy is a hard one. Because you're like, oh, me talking is energy? Yes, you talking is energy. And what is like an experiment that you can do to kind of help prove that sound energy exists?
You can have a cup, like just a little plastic cup, and then you can poke a little hole in it, just like a little pencil hole, and you can stick a string to it.
And then do that on the other side again.
Yes.
And then, but
then
make
you talk
sure
through it
and
make
the
sure
other
that
you can
yeah.
tighten it. Make sure that you, whenever you
yep.
tighten it, because if it's loose, it doesn't let it produce.
Yeah. So, that proves that sound energy exists, because that sound energy will travel across the string from one person's mouth to the other person's ear, which shows us that sound energy exists. So that is our five forms of energy. Okay, let's give a big round of applause for our helpers here. They did great. We love learning about energy. All right, and till the next episode of Science with Mr. Meany.
Peace.